Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in. We are continuing our discussion about the mechanics of materials lab number 5, which is the three-point bending. In this video, we're going to talk about the last two exercises that you need to complete for your report. The first one is plotting the force deflection diagram and finding the slope in the linear region. This is the data set that you have received for the specimen. This is the elastic region. You need to plot this diagram and need to find the slope in this region. So that's number three. Please make sure that you have a title and you have the, what is the x-axis and the y-axis, and you have units so that you can make it, you know, a very clear diagram and indicate all the force deflection information that you need to identify. The fourth exercise that is expected from you is to calculate the elastic modulus of the specimen. Remember, we are doing three-point bending. It's different from the compression and tension. So for the three-point bending, the calculation for the elastic modulus, it needs a couple of intermediate steps. To calculate the elastic modulus of the specimen, we have something called bending stiffness. And bending stiffness, it's not the elastic modulus. It's the slope of the force deflection curve, which is this one. So this curve here, this slope, that's what we call the bending stiffness. It's the slope of force deflection, and that's K. We know from three-point bending analysis that deflection is given in this formula. So P is F, it's the force. So F or P L cube divided by 48, E is the elastic modulus, and I is the moment of inertia. This is deflection. So you need to divide P by tilde. It's going to be 48 EI divided by L cube. This is the bending stiffness, which is the slope of the force deflection curve. This is force, this is deflection. You put force divided by deflection and you rearrange your formula. It will get force divided by deflection. It will be 48 EI divided by L cube. So this is the formula. Now, if you have the slope from the curve here, from this curve, if we got the slope, then I can say, well, okay, this is my slope here. So I can rearrange this formula to get E. So E is going to be the slope multiplied by L cube divided by 48 multiplied by the moment of inertia. So this is rearranging this formula, assuming that the slope is given. This side is given from this analysis, and this side here is given from your data, from the slope from our data that we sent you. You have the slope, you have the length of the specimen, that's L, 48, and then we have the moment of inertia. You remember we calculated the moment of inertia previously using the formula that I is equal BH cube divided by 12. B is the width, H is the thickness, and that's a constant. So if you plugged all of them here in I, you will get the elastic modulus as the slope multiplied by the length cube multiplied by 12 divided by 48. B is the width of the specimen and H is the thickness of the specimen. The elastic modulus is related to the slope of the data that we have here, but it's a little bit different from the compression and tension in the sense that you need to do this, the calculations of to add dimensional structural calculations to get your elastic modulus if you are doing three-point bending. I hope that was helpful and that you are able now to complete your report. If you have any questions, please ask. Thank you for watching. Until the next video. Bye.